That's in my record.
Yes, can I speak to Cliff, please?
Sorry, to?
Cliff. Cliff Richard.
You want to speak to Cliff Richard?
Yes, please. Is he not there?
No.
Oh, is there anybody who can put me through to him?
Are you a fan?
I am indeed, aren't you?
Of course, yeah. But no, he doesn't come here every day.
No. No, I suppose he doesn't. He's playing tennis, isn't he?
It's Shuttleworth Showtime! Yes, indeed. It's Shuttleworth Showtime!
Yes, indeed. And on tonight's show, Carter USM will attempt to rebuild their reputation after coming over as a bit dainty on Come Play With John a few weeks ago. Mark Thomas will be hoping to make my wife Mary merry. And the other things as well.
Shuttleworth Showtime. Oh, yes. It's Shuttleworth Showtime.
Yes, that's right. We've got another visiting bard, I believe. I'll be showing you how to make a demo. And Cindy from Eastenders will be coming to play with me.
Please be seated for this week's edition of Shuttleworth Showtime.
I hope Ian doesn't find out. Oh, no. yeah, hello. John Shuttleworth here, coming to you, as ever, from my through lounge in my house in Sheffield, South Yorkshire. The BBC are still refusing to pay me my petrol money to come down to London for the show, which suits me fine, actually, because it gives me time in between records to play in the edge of an internal door, which has become slightly proud. Anyway, in a minute I'll be talking to Cliff Richard, live on the telephone. They've got me on hold at the moment, you see. In the meantime, you're no doubt wondering what I've been up to in the last week. Well, nothing really. No, not really. I was going to go to the reservoir today to check the level, but I forgot. So I didn't, you know. Oh, excuse me.
Consumer information.
Hello, is Cliff there, please?
Okay.
Cliff Richard, is he there by any chance?
No.
Right, I'm ringing because I've got a Christmas song for him to sing, and there's not much time.
Well, he's got a single already coming out next week.
You're joking?
No.
Is it going to be number one, though?
I've no idea. We'll have to wait and see what the competition's like.
Yeah, well, you see, this song would be guaranteed number one.
Well, this one's already pressed and ready to go, I'm afraid, so...
Yeah, well...
Can't help you.
Could you not put me on the B-side?
No.
So it's very strong. It's all about an orphan. Right. And it would be a little bit different for Cliff, you know.
Well, you won't be able to get it through for Christmas now.
Hmm. I see. What's it called in his single?
All I Have to Do Is Dream.
That's an oldie.
It is, yeah.
Oh, goodness me. That's a sorry state of affairs, isn't it? Well, listen, I've got to go now because I've got to try and find Cliff.
Okay.
Before it's too late.
Okay.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Yeah, I've got to find the number for Wimbledon because that's where he'll be, isn't it? Knocking up, you know. Right, this is the Stone Roses, which is the baggy beat, isn't it, they do? Is it Fusion 1 or something? Number 22, I think. It's called Love Spreads.
Hints and tips, hints and tips. John Shuttleworth's hints and tips. Sound advice from expert lips. John Shuttleworth's hints and tips.
And this week I'm going to tell you how to make a demo. This item has been forced on me because of the appalling standard of the previous week's demos.
Mm,
in fact, I've abandoned the item until further notice. Actually, we've had a letter from the mother of that devil worshipper that we had on last week.
Oh.
And she said that he's lovely. He helps an old man get dressed every Tuesday.
Oh.
And teaches percussion to the unemployed. Mm. But I don't buy that for a second. Do you, Ken?
Mm. Nah. Maybe not.
Ken?
Yes, John?
What do we do then? How do we make a demo? Tell us, because, you know, obviously the listeners need to know.
Yes. Well, first of all, you shut all the windows.
Yeah.
And then you turn the telly down.
Yeah. Or shortly off, Ken. Mm. Ideally.
Well, yes, in an ideal world, yes.
Yeah. But, yeah, it's not always possible, is it?
But, and you should use a high-quality oxygen tape.
I know what you mean, with the chrome thingy.
Yes.
Yeah. All right, so we've done that.
Mm.
Then what do we do?
Press record.
Or play and record at the same time. Sometimes, isn't it, Ken?
Yes, granted.
Ah, yeah.
You caught me out there, didn't you?
But before you commence recording, it is crucial that you do a thorough vocal warm-up.
You lord who have everything.
Oh, that'll happen.
You lord who can do it all. You said you were going to see if you could listen to my cry. I wait until I die.
And you should tune your guitar as well. That goes without saying. It's rubbish, that, isn't it? This highly original piece, inspired, as I understand it, by the worsening situation in Croatia, is ruined because they've left the microphone outside the studio. And, you know, the sound just doesn't carry.
No.
It's a shame. Oh.
That's what? It's not as what, is it, John?
I don't know. Maybe it is.
Oh.
But it brings us on to microphone technique. You see, one, two, ha! See, that's too close.
Oh,
it can damage the equipment.
Mm.
And it can damage yourself as well. Because I sang at a garden party last summer. It was to raise money to send poorly youngsters to Disney World.
Oh, yes.
We didn't actually raise enough, so we had to take them to the Aberdale Industrial Hamlet for the day.
Oh.
I drove the minibus.
Yes.
But I was singing Men at Work's Do You Come From the Land Down Under?
Oh, lovely.
And I was too close, you know, and I chipped my tooth on the grill.
Oh.
It was my own fault, really. You know, I was too cocky with it.
Mm.
It was that bit about the Vegemite sandwich.
Yes. You know?
So don't get too close. But that's too far away.
Oh, yes. Yes.
That's about right.
Mm.
Certainly it's the right level to remind you that I'm John Shuttleworth.
And I'm Ken Worthington.
Ken.
Sorry.
And you're listening to... Shuttleworth Showtime. Don't know what Simon will make of that. That's Shut Up and Dance, Save It Till the Morning After, with a very clever pun on morning. It's a gentle rap track about the pressing situation of the homeless amid the rise of teenage pregnancy. That's what it says on the box. Oh, aha!
It's this week's visiting bard, who's travelled many a yard to make a living from delivering verses to which no one pays the tiniest regard. Must be ever so hard, but no,
don't go.
You're welcome, visiting bard.
What is your name, visiting bard?
My name is Tony Roach.
Right, well, if you're a poet, please now show it. Give us a little poem, Tony. Ideally, it should rhyme and mention lambs.
Mm-hmm. My name is Tony Roach. I came here by coach.
Yes.
I didn't see any lambs. I don't think you're allowed to take them on coaches.
Oh, well, that's a bit monk-like, wasn't it? Gregorian, chanting, you know. But the first two lines rhymed, certainly, so in you come.
Thanks.
Right, take those boots off, they're a bit muddy.
Right.
Because you've been traipsing through fields, haven't you, from the last village.
Fields, yep.
You must be tired, visiting bard. Go through to the lounge. Take this fun-sized Snickers with you.
Ooh,
and Lucas Aid Sport.
Oh, lovely.
Hey, don't make too much noise eating it, you know, because remember we're doing a broadcast. Oh, excuse me. See you in a minute, Tony. Hello?
Hello, can I speak to Mary Shuttleworth, please?
Yeah, who's calling?
It's Mark Thomas.
And what's it concerning?
I'd quite like to make Mary merry, if that's all right with you.
Oh, I see. Yes, that's fine.
Make Mary merry, make her laugh. Alternative comedy is funny, not naff.
Does she like sort of Morecambe and Wise?
Yeah, but they're not around anymore, are they?
I know, but if she likes that kind of thing, I think she'll like me.
Oh, well, all right then. I mean, she likes Ken Dodd.
Does Tarby, she like Ken Dodd?
Stan Boardman, that sort
Doddy
of thing.
Doddy and I get on really well.
Do you?
Yeah, we're cast from the same mould.
Well, that stands in your favour then, lad. You should do very well. Anyway, okay, she's just coming up.
Okay, thank you.
Put your dishcloth down, love.
All right.
Been defrosting the fridge.
Yeah, that's right.
But you don't need to do that now because...
No, come on.
Hang on. Are you ready, Mark?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Right. You have a mere minute in which to make merry... Oh, start again.
Oof.
I'm excited. Sorry.
Don't know
you
why.
You have a mere minute in which to make Mary merry.
Okay.
Start. Hang on.
Okay, I'm sorry. I'm too excited.
Yeah, well... Calm down.
John.
Okay, I'm in...
Both of us, calm down.
Okay, because it's getting quite heady.
Come on.
Yes, and it's not that important.
It isn't.
Well, it is important for you.
Well, it is, because obviously it means a lot, you know.
Yeah.
If I can just bring one smile to Mary's face, then that...
Well, if you do that, you'll be doing better than the previous two contestants.
Mm. Okay, then.
Because
yes,
they Mary didn't laugh at all.
No.
All right, here we go. You have a mere minute in which to make Mary merry. Starting from...
John, come here.
Yeah, love.
Yeah, thank you.
Now!
Mary. Mm. Now, you will have undoubtedly heard of a woman called Victoria Gillick. She's quite a well-known pro-life and anti-contraception campaigner.
That's what it is.
But she actually said, and this is a quote, that contraception was evil because sperm was a form of life. So if sperm is a form of life, what that means, in fact, is that keeping them in my testicles, then, that's battery sperm, isn't it? That's actually imprisonment. I should be up there on Clapham Commons strumming away going, run free, my beauties, free as the wind, run with them, my free-range lovelies.
Yeah.
I should be there doing that.
Yeah.
Because I think people's opinions of contraception and abortion would be very, very different if Jesus had been a woman. You see, if Jesus had been a woman, she would have actively campaigned for contraception. She would have preached it. She would have been there going, girls, always use two condoms. You can never be too careful, girls. You can never be too careful.
Jump.
My mum didn't even have sex and she got pregnant. You can never be too careful. That means then that if Jesus is a woman, then things like menstruation, that actually is a sacred act. That means we'll have tampons with string and a little crucifix hanging off the end of
Mark
it.
Mark Thomas, your minute is off.
Disgusting.
How did I do?
I heard that, lad.
Dad,
what do you think you're doing?
I was trying to make Mary merry.
Wash your mouth out. Disgraceful.
You should be blushing, lad. I hope you are.
Well, I am now.
Yeah.
I thought she was up for... I thought she liked Ken Dodd.
You duped us, didn't you?
I didn't.
You duped us saying it was going to be like Markham and Wise and that.
Oh, I didn't.
You tricked us.
Oh, I'm sorry. What advice would you give me, then?
Well, why don't you think about a career switch? You know, you're still a young man. You could perhaps be a runner in a DHS office or something like that. Solicitor's clerk. Or a fireman. What's about a fireman? Because you're quite stockily built, aren't you?
I'd like to be a fireman.
I can imagine you carrying, you know, hysterical victim up a ladder. Well, down a ladder, to be.
Yeah, I mean, down a ladder would be much better. I mean, if I was carrying a hysterical victim up there, she would be hysterical, or he would be hysterical, because I was going to be throwing them in.
That's right, yeah. I made a mistake there, and you picked me up on it. Yeah, obviously not going to take him back to the scene of the accident, are you?
Because it would be quite distressing.
Yeah, it would.
If you've just say, if you've had a chip pan fire.
Yeah. Well, you wouldn't be taking, there'd be no ladders involved, because it would be the kitchen, ground floor. Unless the fire engine's very high. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Well, listen, I'm sorry, John, and if I give Mary some roses, would that you know, the roses chocolates, would that make up for it? If I sent them round, would that be an apology enough?
What size?
Well, standard.
What, the little box or the big one?
The little box. Well, I'll get a big box. Do you think
get the big one. Get the tin, because it's Christmas time coming up, and you give the tin at Christmas, don't you?
Okay, I'll get Mary a tin of roses.
And make sure it's sealed.
Okay.
All right.
All right, thanks a lot, John.
All right, Mark.
Bye.
God bless. Bye-bye. No. Oh. He's ruining his voice, that lad. He's going to regret it when he comes to make a speech at a brewery promotion or service mess, you know. Anyway, let's have another demo now. And this one shows you how to harness the latest technical wizardry while still maintaining the melody. It's very clever. Have a listen. Yeah.
Mm.
What do you think of that then, Ken?
Yes. That's lovely.
Yeah.
Yeah. Very reminiscent of Lindsay DePaul, that vocalist.
Yes, they are.
Yes, I'd sign them up tomorrow.
Would you?
Are they available for representation, do you know?
I've no idea, Ken, and it's none of your business, really, is it?
Well.
If you handle me, you know, you're my agent, Ken.
Yes. Hello.
Background noise, the perennial problem for the demo enthusiasts. This haunting harmonium piece is ruined by what sounds like a waterfall or a jug kettle nearing boiling point.
Yes.
They didn't follow Ken's advice on eradicating background noise.
They didn't, no.
Ken?
Jan?
Yes?
What?
Jan, can you get me the ironing board out, please, love?
Later, Mary.
No, now, please. Come on.
Ooh.
Thank you.
Oh, Jan. You better go.
No.
No.
Ken, I won't. Because we're about to record my demo for Cliff.
Yes.
And it's very important.
Mm.
And we've got Karen here, my daughter. She very kindly agreed to play recorder. And her friend Maxine, who's very good on the guitar. She's good at finger picking. Though, as she freely admits, she's not so good at the moment because she's been biting her nails.
Yeah, I have.
Because her boyfriend Clark has just finished with her. And she's devastated. Aren't you, love?
I'm not.
Oh, you must be.
No.
You must be, you know, your first love.
It's not a first love.
Oh. What? Ken! What are you doing? Put it down.
Nice answer.
Look, why don't you sit down in the big leather chair and start taking notes or something?
What for?
Because you're the producer. That's what producers do.
Oh, right. John?
What?
Can I have some paper, please?
Sorry, you caught me to lock it. Yes, a little bit out there, George, at the end, wasn't it? But still, that's marvellous, that. Very clever. Right, I'm going to ring Wimbledon now to get in contact with Cliff.
God made the world and everything in it.
Tony's recited
God
to Ken in the room.
God made the trees and the birds and the bees. God made the vegetables, the mushrooms and peas. God made the people, the French and Japanese. But most important of all, God gave us cheese. The Bible said man cannot live by bread alone and thereby acknowledge the sacred and holy nature of cheese. God has made it clear to us that we should be grateful for cheese, and I, for one, would not argue with God. However, having said that, when you pass your driving test, what you really want from your parents is a car and not a Dairy Lee triangle.
Oh, that's lovely, Tony. Are you available for representation, by any chance? Because, yeah. You know... Quite like to represent you. Are you?
Yeah, I am actually. Oof. Yeah.
Right.
Well, then, Cav, good afternoon.
Yes, hello. Is Cliff there by any chance?
Cliff who?
Cliff Richard.
Cliff Richard?
Yeah. Well, I just thought, you know, he's quite keen on tennis. Thought he might be practicing his ground strokes or something.
No.
Because I need to get in contact with him urgently about his Christmas release. Oof.
Alison Edwards.
Hello, yes, I'm trying to contact Cliff Richard. You see, I need to contact him urgently about his Christmas single. He's putting out an oldie, and it's going to flop for him. And I've got a brand-new song, which is a little bit different, you know, and it's all about a little boy whose parents perish in a house fire. And, you know, it'd be just right for him. I just thought he might be down there today knocking up, you know, because it's quite fine up here.
No, he's not down here today.
Right, so he's not in the bar or anything with Sue or anything?
No.
Does she come down quite a lot, doesn't she?
Fair about, yes. Yeah.
Yeah. But he's not going out with her anymore, is he?
No.
Or is he?
Oh, do you mean Sue Barker? No, she doesn't come down. No.
You haven't got access to his locker or anything? I could, might be, you know, scrap a paper with her contact number.
No, I can't possibly do that.
No. That's a bit rude, isn't it?
No.
It's Christmas time! Well, this is what Cliff's missing. My demo with Dolby of The Christmas Orphan. No Maxine on guitar, her fingernails were just too short, you know. And Karen couldn't get a recording tune. But they do feature on backing vocals.
The village school lies empty, all covered in snow. But on the steps a little boy sits, he's got nowhere to go. His parents were overcome by fumes when fire swept through their home. Now he's a Christmas orphan all alone. Christmas is a time for the family, but for an orphan, how can it be? You've got your presents around the Christmas tree. What's an orphan got? Just his memories. The little boy gets to his feet and wipes the tears from his eyes. Then he sets off down the lonely street. Where are you, Mummy? He cries. He's so cold and wishes he was at home. He doesn't know he's a Christmas orphan all alone. Christmas is a time for the family.
That's gorgeous. Do you like it? Well, someone's got to want to release that, haven't they? Yeah, but who? Johnny Hates Jazz? Denise Nolan? Well, I'll have a think about that. during the news, which is coming up now. Still to come, we've got Michelle Collins, Cindy from EastEnders, more poems from Tony Roach, our visiting bard, Nancy Boys Carter, and this week's edition of the biblical drama, Amen.
Office, hello.
Hello, yes. I'm trying to get in contact with Russ Abbott.
Russ, yes, more connection.
Well, I've got a Christmas single for him.
Russ has no plans to record for the foreseeable future.
Oh, why is that?
I don't know the reasoning, I'm afraid.
Because this would be just right for us. You know, it's a little
bit... he has no plans to record at all, I'm afraid.
What about comedian Roy Walker? You handle him, don't you, as well?
Yes, indeed.
Because he'd be dead right for it with his Lilton Irish brogue. It's a song that's about a little boy who's an orphan. His parents die in a house fire. I could sing a little bit of it.
No, don't.
Because I could see the video. You could do like a catchphrase, you know, with like a match and a house, you know, house on fire, you know. Has Roy got plans to release a Christmas single?
What, this Christmas?
Yeah, we're going to get a cassette to you with Dolby on.
Yeah.
So it wouldn't be too hissy, you know. And then Roy could just sing over the top. Or he could just... speak the words, and you could say catchphrase or whatever now and again, just if you wanted to, you know.
Well, I just don't think it's not the sort of thing he does, I'm afraid.
Is he not a vocalist?
Sorry?
Is he not a vocalist?
No, I mean, he's primarily a comic.
Yeah, he could be trained, couldn't he?
Well, not before Christmas.
Well, I don't mind teaching him. You know, he could come round to our house or go through it with him on the organ, give him his tea, you know.
It doesn't quite work that way.
Yeah. You haven't got a number for Leo Sayer, have you?
Afraid not, no.
Chain of Fools by Aretha Franklin from Queen of Soul, the very best of. Now, is it my imagination or is it one or two wrong notes there? It sounded a bit like Maxine on guitar, didn't it, at times? Anyway, now it's time for...
Come play with John, it will be fun. And as we play, we'll idly chat away.
And this week, I'm joined by Michelle Collins, who is playing Principal Boy, aren't you?
That's right, John.
What are you doing?
I'm doing Jack and the Beanstalk, and I'm Jack.
Do you know, I knew you'd do that. Yeah, she just smacked her thigh. Yeah, it's quite a sturdy thigh, isn't it?
Yeah.
Is that the side you always hit yourself on?
It depends. Sometimes I go on that side.
That's a better noise, that, isn't it? Yeah. Can I suggest you put a little piece of lint there just to absorb the impact?
That's a good idea,
Under your tights,
because you do get slapped quite a lot.
So that's something to bear in mind. Listen, we're just gabbling away and nothing's been done. Your chosen sport is what, Michelle?
Darts.
Is that so you can feel at home in the Vic, you know?
I've never played darts in the Vic, actually.
Have you not?
No, it's a bit of a sexist pub. You never see the girls playing, so I thought it'd be a good idea to play.
Well, you say you play, but I notice your foot is straying over the hockey.
But I haven't started yet.
No, that's right. Well, get your darts. Here we are. Start with a double. Go on.
Right. Oh!
Is it the wall?
You better get out of the way in case it goes back. Yes! What's that, 17?
17 you scored, yes.
That's your
bullseye. A bullseye! I can start with the bullseye. We're away.
Yes! 13.
So listen, in EastEnders, you're... having a snog with that bloke in the swimming baths, aren't you?
That's right.
And understand that you might be going back there.
The swimming pool?
Yeah, but can I make a suggestion?
What?
If he's there in the pool...
Avoid him.
Just stay in the foyer and just have a hot chocolate in a wagon wheel from the vending machine, you know. Because that's fine, you know.
It wasn't my choice. I wasn't allowed to be on the cast. No, he's very nice.
Yeah.
I just think she'll eat him for dinner, really.
That's right. She will. So, I understand you used to sing with Mary Wilson.
That's right. And the Wilsatians.
Yeah.
And I was called Candide.
Were you?
Candy Collins. So that's quite glamorous, doesn't it?
Yeah, she used to have a beehive, didn't she?
But that's right. But we had mini beehives.
Yeah, but she had a swarm, didn't she? No, it's gone.
We had blisters.
Yeah.
because we were only the sort of babies, you know, so we had to have blisters. Yeah.
I don't understand that. What do you mean?
Well, because she was the star. She had the big beehive and we had the mini beehives.
What are you talking about? Blisters? What
well, they were like sort of little...
Like a blister?
Blisters, like overblown, yeah.
Well, an open wound? What do you mean?
Oh, I'll tell you another time.
Well, there won't be another time. This is your one chance to tell me. What do you mean?
All right, I had a mini beehive, all right. But to me, it just looked like a sort of blister.
I see.
You know.
Ooh.
Like you want to sort of poke it, you know.
Yeah, oh, I
sort
see.
Sort of nesting.
I see.
You know.
I'm with you now. Yes! Double one! I've won.
Have you? Damn.
You don't
I seem practising
too...
in that pub, hadn't I? Well, thanks for having me.
So, lovely to meet you, Michelle.
I'd love to meet you. I've heard so much about you.
Have you?
Yeah.
Has it been a perfect day?
Absolutely.
No, the reason I asked that is that this next song is called A Perfect Day, and it's by Milk and Honey.
Oh, wow. What an intro.
Nothing like that, but I'm sorry, but I am quite a good singer, and it's a very passable
This man is a big head,
of these two songs,
and it puts you
so
against him.
Listen.
Which highlights the importance of presenting yourself well, orally.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, he says thank you at the end, but it's too late. You're against him, because he's been boasting. And you shouldn't do that when you're making demos. But you shouldn't be too shy either, or aloof. Like Carter were, when I interviewed them a few weeks ago, on Alan's Big One. They came over as a bit snooty, you know, and they lost all the fans. The following just crumbled overnight, you know. It's been awful for them. Anyway, Carter have contacted me and asked me if I'll help them re-establish their credibility. So I'm going off now to a secret hideaway address to see what we can do for them.
Amen, older brother of Jesus. And it came to pass that no one took any notice of Amen. So once again, he tried to find a different form of self-expression outside the drudgery of carpentry.
God save us and protect us. What harebrained scheme have you come up with now?
Well, you can call it what you like, Mother. But tonight sees the opening of Nazareth's first seafood restaurant, Amen's Seafood Shack.
So that's what you've been up to when you disappear in the evenings? And who, pray tell me, is going to run the carpentry shop while you're away at this so-called...
Restaurant, Mother. Yes, restaurant. Well, it seems to me that golden boy Jesus is just going to have to take some time off being Mr. Big Man Messiah for a while and return to his roots as a carpenter, isn't he? Oh, Jesus thinks he owns every single fish in the ocean. Well, he doesn't. His apostles may be fishermen, and he may be a fisher of men. But I am a man of the fish.
You're talking through your backside again, Amen.
So, we found you at last.
Tell your father what you've been up to.
Certainly, I've been putting the final touches to my restaurant, Father. It's the official opening tonight, actually.
A seafood restaurant, no less.
Is that a fact? I love a bit of fish myself. I used to do a lot of fishing when I was a young lad. I'll never forget the time I caught a fish one day from the riverbank and threw it back in the water, as you do. And the next day, I caught the exact same fish. An amazing coincidence, but it definitely recognised me. It gave me a really filthy look. A fish never forgets a face.
Okay, folks, this way for the
What's
whole
all that noise about outside?
Oh, not again. It's a chariot load of bloody Abyssinian tourists. Just because they haven't got their own cultural history themselves, they have to come to Nazareth to annoy us. Just look at them in their stupid purple and yellow togas and their silly hats. What
hey,
are you like?
How you doing, you guys? Is this where the fella Jesus lives? Ah, this place is so quaint.
How kind of you to say so.
Hey, is the Jesus guy around today? Any chance of him performing a miracle for us?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
That'd be something to tell the folks back home.
I'm afraid my son, the Messiah, isn't here today.
Ah.
Say, you must be his mother, the Virgin Woman.
That I am.
Say, you mind if I get a drawing of you?
Well, maybe some other time. Are you all followers of Jesus?
Oh, sure in hell. The guy's really big in Abyssinia.
Yeah.
Well, reckon we better be going. You see, we still got to take in Bethlehem and the Lake of Galilee, you know, on today's tour.
God bless you on your journey.
See you around.
Bye.
Okay, guys, on your donkeys for the Mount of Olives.
What in the name of God are all these things lying around the place?
Those things, as you call them, Mother, happen to be menus.
Prawn provencal tastefully garnished on a pillow of wild mushrooms. The Lord between us on all harm, I've never heard the likes.
Provençal, actually, Mother.
You're getting a bit too big for your boots, if you ask me.
I've heard that the prawn is a bit of a manic depressive, not a happy fish.
Well, I haven't time to be hanging around here all day. I've a pile of Jesus' socks and underwear to iron.
At 8 o'clock that evening, Eamon proudly opened the doors of his new restaurant. By 9:30, there was no signs of any customers, with the exception of two teenage girls called Karen and Imelda.
Can we have another coffee, handsome?
My name happens to be Eamon.
Ooh, touchy!
No, you can't have another coffee, actually. This is a seafood restaurant, not one of those cheap cafes you normally frequent. Now, come on, clear off. Out. Come on, out, clear off.
Does Jesus eat here? What sort of music does Jesus like?
I don't know and I don't care. Come on, out, clear off. Out! Clear off!
It's Shuttleworth Showtime!
Well, we're in a little hotel now, in a nice part of Sheffield, quite residential district, family-run hotel, and we're here for a very good reason, which I'll tell you in a minute. When I say we, I mean me and Carter USM. Hello, lads.
Hi, John.
You all right?
Yeah, hello. All right.
Yeah. You see, listeners to The Big One will remember when I was guesting on it, you came on, didn't you? You came and played with me, and... played table tennis.
Badly,
yes, but there was a problem because what happened? You came over too nicely, didn't you? Quite dainty, some might say.
I think it was edited.
It was edited, yes. No, it wasn't. It was live. What are you talking about? Like this is. Like this is. But to cut a long story short, you're not happy with the way you came over. It's cost you a lot of fans.
Yeah.
The media have turned against you.
Record sales have gone right down.
Have they?
Yeah, it's
stopped.
Terrible.
Record sales have stopped.
Well,
that's why we come here to put it right.
That's right. Well, you did the right thing to come here to this hotel room. So tell me, what are you going to do?
We're going to throw a television out of the window of this very hotel.
Yeah. Well, I don't approve of that, but I can see why you need to do it. Looking at the television, it's a Pi 18-inch. There's no remote, but very nice set in its day. Because we used to sell these when I used to work for Commie back in the 70s. And it's just a terrible thing to do, to throw it out the window. Right, we're going to open the window. Right, lads, do you want to grab the telly?
Right.
I should point out to worry pedestrians that we have cordoned off a bit of the street. Ken's there supervising, making sure the children don't. Look quite menacing if you can.
Unplug the aerial.
Which one's the aerial?
Yeah, next to the... No, that's the main. Turn it off the plug first.
Well, I can't reach down there.
No.
What are you doing?
I can't reach the
aerial. Look, you're supposed to be spontaneous, isn't it? You're supposed to, like, be quite angry.
It's not as easy as you
and wanting and just...
TV.
You're supposed to rip the plug out. He's on his knees, daintily trying to... Get... Come here, you Nancy boys. Give it to me. This is what you do. Just pick it up, wrench. Oh, blimey.
Oh, no.
I'm sorry.
Oh,
all damages will be paid for.
Would you like a locket, John?
Yes. Yes, I would.
I think we all need one.
Yes.
It's time for John's brief sit-down.
Oh, I need this. Blimey. I ran out the wind, Tony. Ran out the wind to get to you. I'm going to read the paper. What are you going to do?
I'll read out a poem, if that's okay.
That'd be lovely. And I'll have a sip of me hot chocolate.
Right.
Go on.
Okay, this one's called A Typical School Day. 8:45 a.m. Dad throws me out of speeding car onto school driveway. 8:55 a.m. Have head flushed down toilet by other kids. 9 a.m. Registration. 9:30 a.m. Double metal work. Get hit over the head with bits of metal for an hour. 10:30 a.m. Double woodwork. I am forced to help in the construction of my own coffin. 12 o'clock, lunch. Have head flushed down toilet by dinner ladies. 1 p.m. Chemistry. I am used in an experiment to determine the boiling point of skin. 2 p.m. Double physics. I am used in an experiment to determine whether or not the human genitals are a good conductor of electricity. 3:30 p.m. Go home. Decide to give up supply teaching.
I don't believe that. Because dinner ladies don't do things like you described. They supervise. But you know, my wife, mate, she's a dinner lady. She wouldn't do things like that. Silly. Not true, is it, really?
It is true.
Didn't. Says here that police are still looking for two youths who moved an antique wagon wheel 100 yards from outside a pub after a late-night drinking spree. One's described as stockily built, with ginger hair, and the other's of Mediterranean colouring, and was wearing a yellow lycra top. Any information to Detective Sergeant Alan Harker? He's dealing with this one.
Is that true?
It is, yeah.
No, it's not true, is it? You made that up.
It's a paper, lad. Oh, Sweets in a Jar was won by Amanda Thicket. Go on, give us another poem then.
All right.
It's off to go in a minute.
This one's called Mary, Mary.
Hang on, that's mine. My song. Mary, Mary, when I met you I was wary. You said my arms were hairy, now that was unnecessary. It's my song, isn't it, about my wife.
But this is my poem and it's different to that.
Go on then, prove it.
Okay. Mary, Mary, quite contrary.
Yeah.
How does your garden grow? Who are you calling contrary and piss off out of my garden?
Yeah, that's quite clever, I suppose.
Yeah.
But it isn't mine, you're right, it was different.
Yeah.
It was a bit like another one. Oh, we've got to go.
Time to get up off the sofa. John, your brief sit-down is over. Come on, what we get?
Right, come on, Tony. Can you put your shoes on, please, now, and get ready to leave? Can you wash up your mug and your side plate as well before you go?
Yeah, right.
Yeah. It's time to move on. Dark Hearts by Bomb the Bass, featuring Spiky T. Hey, I've been a fool, because I don't need a big star to sing me Christmas song, do I? I know Leo Sayer is going to be disappointed, but I'm going to release my version with me singing. You see, I've thought of a way to guarantee it becomes a massive hit that'll have every record company queuing up, desperate to release it. Right, who shall I try first? I know, Cliff's label. Right, here goes.
Get off
tuning
my record.
Yes, A&R, please.
Anyone in particular?
No.
Hello?
Yes, hello. I've got a Christmas single which I think you might be interested in.
Ah, let me just tell you now, it's too late for the Christmas market for us to get things released.
What if I told you I could guarantee 60 plays on Radio 1 before Christmas?
Really? Can you?
Yes.
Right, well, okay, do you want to send it in?
Yes, I will.
Okay, then. Have you got our address?
I have.
Okay, then.
I'll do
send
that.
Send it in and we'll get someone to get back to you as soon as possible.
Thank you very much.
Cheers.
And I have to say, I know you're releasing Cliff.
Yeah.
But this will knock him off the top spot.
Oh, right, okay then.
Can guarantee it.
I look forward to getting it.
Thank you very much.
Cheers.
Bye bye. Wake up, Christmas oven, and come with me. The angel took him by the hand and led him through the snowy skies. At last they came to the heavenly gates. Who is it? St. Peter cried. It's me and the Christmas orphan. Please let him come inside, so he can be with his parents at Christmas time. Yes, Christmas is a time for the family, and for the little boy, that's how it's going to be. He walked in through those gates and saw his family, his mom and dad and God in all his majesty. La 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 la. Well, that's going to be the show for the next 3 weeks till the end of the series. My song played over and over again. Can you stand it? No, you know, it grows on you. It does. And Mark Radcliffe will play it, won't you, Mark? And I know somebody who knows one of the night cleaners at Radio Sheffield. They can slip him a copy. So watch out, Cliff. I'm on your tail. Anyway, thanks for listening. And thanks to Michelle Collins, Mark Thomas, Tony Roach and Carter, about whom I'm still not convinced. Ooh. I think they need to bring back the little strand of hair that they used to have.